published 1848 EDT, the 29th of October 2017 updated 825 EDT, the 30th of October 2017 Theresa May today vowed to act against MPs found to be pests and refused to say she has confidence in a serving minister after a dirty dossier surfaced about Tory politicians. A hit list of 36 sitting Conservative MPs branded pests, including two serving cabinet members, has emerged in a secret spreadsheet of shame leaked at Westminster. One MP is said to be handsy with women at parties, another perpetually intoxicated and very inappropriate with women. One minister was said to have had UAL relations with a researcher and another paid a woman to be quiet. A former Tory minister was said to have propositioned his secretary by asking her to come and feel the length of my sea. Tory aides have put together the dirty dossier, which includes the specific details of the accusations, inappropriate or even criminal behaviour at work. The Prime Minister's official spokesman made clear today that she would not hesitate to punish MPs found to have behaved inappropriately. The spokesman also refused to say that Mrs. May had confidence in International Trade Minister Mark Garnier, who faces a formal probe into claims he made his secretary Caroline Edmondson buy toys for him and called her sugar TTS in public. He denies UAL harassment and says the allegations are exaggerated. Mrs. May will be in the Commons later when Leader of the House Andrea Leadsom makes a statement on the burgeoning row. The PM has already written to Commons Speaker John Bercow to demand a shake-up of toothless disciplinary procedures. Female staff at Westminster are naming and shaming pest MPs on a secret WhatsApp group. It has been revealed this grab comes from the Conservative Party dirty dossier, with names of MPs blacked out. International Trade Minister Mark Garnier, pictured at a trans pride event, is accused of calling his secretary Sugar TTS in front of witnesses. The list includes two serving cabinet ministers who are accused of inappropriate behavior towards women and 18 ministers facing allegations of inappropriate UAL behavior. Reports Guido Fawkes. Another 12 MPs are accused of behaving inappropriately towards female staff, while 4 are alleged to have behaved inappropriately towards male researchers. Yesterday, a journalist said a Tory MP made a drunken lunge at her following a Westminster lunch. Jane Merrick, a columnist with The Times, said she was a young political reporter when she was harassed by the MP who she refused to name, but amid the fresh wave of lurid allegations, one MP warned the claims should not be confused with the very serious accusations against mogul Harvey Weinstein. Rumours were swirling round Parliament last night that two cabinet ministers were among politicians accused of being pests. Both privately insist no allegations have been put to them. Separately, former cabinet minister Stephen Crabb has admitted sending explicit messages to a 19-year-old woman after a job interview in Parliament. Although only Conservative figures have been the subject of the allegations, it is believed senior Labour politicians, including two former frontbenchers, have also been accused. In other developments, Mr. Bercow will chair a hearing early this week to discuss ways to protect MPs' staff. A cabinet minister is alleged to have placed his hand on the thigh of a female journalist and said, "God, I love those tees." Anonymous reports suggested a second senior minister had an affair with a junior female aide who is also now an MP. A Liberal Democrat peer was rumoured to have invited female journalists to lunch, telling them to wear knee-high boots and short skirts, and were said to be sharing stories about a Conservative who allegedly takes pictures of young men in compromising positions and uses them to extract UAL favours. It also emerged that women working at the Scottish Parliament have been victim to a catalogue of UAL harassment incidents. According to a high-profile lawyer, May's former communications chief said whips often kept incriminating evidence to push MPs into following the party line in votes. Last week, Mrs. May described the pest claims as deeply concerning and encouraged victims to report their allegations to the police. Overnight, she wrote to Mr. Bercow to demand the establishment of a grievance procedure to deal with Westminster harassment complaints. The Prime Minister said it is important that those who work in the House of Commons are treated properly and fairly. She criticised the disciplinary procedure operated by Commons WACOG IPSA, because it was not compulsory for MPs to sign up. It does not have the required teeth, as contractually an MP does not have to follow the procedure, she added. Caroline Edmondson pictured in 2013 with her partner. Journalist John Craig is said to have been asked to buy toys for boss Mark Carney. A former cabinet minister Stephen Crabb admitted sending explicit messages to a 19-year-old woman after a job interview at Westminster. "I do not believe that this situation can be tolerated any longer. It is simply not fair on staff, many of whom are young and in their first job post-education. We must establish a house-wide mediation service complemented by a contractually binding grievance procedure available for all MPs irrespective of their party banner. Plans to make all common staff wear name badges were watered down after concerns were raised male MPs would be encouraged to leer at women's chests. The proposals floated by the House authorities 3 years ago received an angry response with warnings that they could fuel harassment and inappropriate behaviour on the estate. MPs employ their own staff, but the Commons overhauled its procedures several years ago in a bid to offer around 2,000 House officials more protection from abuse by politicians. The respect policy allows for cases against MPs to be taken to the Standards Committee and ruling House of Commons Commission if disciplinary action is deemed to be required. The badge plan was put forward by the Commons authorities in November 2014 in an effort to generate more of a customer service ethos and improve relations between its staff and MPs. It was backed by the Commons Governance Committee, chaired at the time by Labour MP Jack Straw. But when staff were asked for their views, the idea produced complaints from women and from men worried about how female colleagues would be affected. Details revealed under Freedom of Information rules highlighted concerns MPs already harass and abuse them, and forcing people to wear name badges would make things worse. One response stated, "I think badges risk making younger junior staff, especially women, more vulnerable. Harassment and rude inappropriate comments by MPs to staff are still, regrettably, commonplace." Another added, "I am not comfortable with the prospect of people staring at my chest in order to find out who I am." The PM official spokesman said today he would not preempt the findings of the review into Mr. Garnier's behaviour. He rejected questions about whether Mr. Garnier's actions were morally right and referred them to the review. Her spokesman said the probe was ordered very quickly yesterday after the claims about the minister emerged publicly. Asked if Mrs. May had confidence in the trade minister, her spokesman said there is an investigation the Prime Minister has asked for, which is being conducted by the Cabinet Office. The spokesman refused repeatedly to express confidence in Mr. Garnier and did not rebut suggestions her confidence was dependent on the investigation outcome. He said she has been clear any unwanted UAL behaviour is completely unacceptable in any walk of life, and she strongly believes those who work in Parliament are treated properly and fairly as would be expected in any modern workplace. That is why she has written to the Speaker to ask for his support in what can be done to ensure the reputation of Parliament is not damaged by these allegations of impropriety. Asked if the Prime Minister would expect ministers to resign if allegations were proved, the spokesman added the Prime Minister has been clear that this type of behaviour would be inappropriate if proven and appropriate action would be taken. Mrs. May will be on the Commons front bench this afternoon for a statement on the emerging affair by Commons leader Andrea Leadsom. Yesterday, political journalist Jane Merrick told BBC News she had been the victim of an after-lunch pass by a Tory MP. Separately, the Mail on Sunday reported that Mr. Crabb admitted sending explicit messages to a 19-year-old woman he interviewed for a job in 2013, when he was a minister for Wales. The married MP was quoted by the paper as saying there had been no UAL contact. Mr. Crabb resigned last year as Work and Pensions Secretary following reports of a similar incident. Katie Perrier, Mrs. May's former head of communications at Number 10, said incriminating information was often kept away from the Prime Minister but deployed by whips to enforce party discipline. She told BBC Breakfast the information is held by the whips because they use it to make sure that MPs know that other people within the party know exactly what they've been up to, and that behaviour either is not acceptable, or it will be used against them. You will vote in a certain way, or we will tell your wife exactly what you've been up to. Speaking on BBC Radio 4's Westminster Hour last night, Labour former Minister Caroline Flint said goes on in Westminster. On ITV's Good Morning Britain Today, Shadow Home Secretary Diane Abbott stressed that the problems cross party lines. Labour former Minister Caroline Flint said goes on in Westminster. Former Culture Secretary John Whittingdale admitted there was bad behaviour among MPs. Theresa May pictured going to church with husband Philip yesterday, is trying to get a grip on the burgeoning scandal. The MP urged colleagues to get a grip on what being an MP is about, put their egos in a box and stop thinking they're the greatest thing since sliced bread and can do say what they want. Former Culture Secretary John Whittingdale admitted there was bad behaviour among MPs. But he suggested it was down to the nature of Westminster, where you have people who genuinely have some power, all in a place a long way from their families, often until late at night, surrounded by young people who look up to them. Some people abuse that. It does happen and it's cross-party and it's something we need to tackle. I do think it's a minority. I don't think my colleagues are all constantly abusing people, Mr. Whittingdale added. Shadow Home Secretary Diane Abbott stressed that the problems cross party lines. These are 36 Tory MPs, but it's not just a Tory issue. It's an issue for MPs as a whole, she said. Labour MP John Mann called on Mrs. May to sack Mr. Garnier and to remove the whip from Mr. Crabbe. Garnier should be sacked as a minister, obviously that would be sufficient, he said. He Crabbe should be booted out too. What is Theresa May waiting for? Conservative backbencher Andrew Bridgen accused Labour of spreading the allegations against Tory MPs to distract from the furore over their suspended MP Jared O'Mara for making Eastern homophobic comments. He said these rumours have been flying around for years, so why are they coming out now? They're trying to create a distraction. And the unnamed Tory MP who has called for caution said we've got to be very careful that we don't confuse stupid, inappropriate and UAL behaviour, such as getting a member of staff to buy a toy, with what Harvey Weinstein has been accused of. He has been accused of rape, UAL assault and requiring for career advancement. Theresa May has written to Commons Speaker John Bercow to demand a shake-up of toothless disciplinary procedures. The House introduced a respect policy several years ago in a bid to enhance protection for its own staff.